power of a lens. So power of lens is, it is a measure of the degree of convergence or the degree of divergence of the light rays falls on it. That means when the light falls on the lens, how much degree it will be bent towards or bent outwards. That means converging power or diverging power. Imagine that when the light rays falls on the convex lens, that is a converging lens, the light will be converged and fall on the or meet at the focus. So how much degree, the measure of degree of convergence in the convex lens or measure of degree of divergence in the concave lens is called as a power of lens. So the SI unit of power of lens is diopter. So the SI unit of power of lens is diopter. Okay, the SI unit of power of lens is diopter. So very simple. So the power of lens is a reciprocal of focal length. That means, hence the smaller the focal length of the lens, more is the ability to bend the light rays and greater its power. Very simple. If the focal length is very, very small, what will happen? It will bend more, that is the power will be higher. So focal length is smaller means the power will become higher because it is inversely proportional. Hence the ability of the bending will be more. So that is a power of lens. In another way, we can define the power of lens as, the power of lens as defined is defined as the tangent of the angle made by it converges or diverges a beam of light falling at a unit distance from the optical center. So by using this definition, now we are going to derive the derivation. Very simple. What is the definition says? The power of lens is defined as a tangent angle. So the tangent angle, we are taking a tan delta. So this is a delta. So the tangent angle by which it converges. So when a parallel beam of light falls on the convex lens, it will bend down. So actually the light will goes in this direction straight if there is a no convex lens. If the light falls on the convex lens, how much degree it will bend down? Delta degree it will bend down. So this is a measure of degree of convergence. So the tangent of the angle by which it is convergence of a beam light fall on the convex lens from unit distance from the optic center. If the distance is unity, that means we can take an such as a 1. So very simple. I am taking a convex lens, a parallel beam of light falls on the convex lens, it will converge through the focal length or the principal focus. So this is a ray. So this is the angle of bending. If the this is an imaginary line, horizontal line, so the angle of convergence is delta, this angle is also delta, opposite angles equal. So the height of the object is h, means here this height is also h. The distance between the optic center and the focus is f. So tan delta, which is equal to opposite side by adjacent. So opposite side by adjacent, opposite is a h, adjacent is a f. So h by f. By definition, the h value is 1. So tan delta, which is equal to 1 by f. This tangent angle is called as a power of lens. So the power of lens p is equal to 1 by f. The SI unit of power of lens is diopter. So the diopter is, one diopter is defined as 1 meter inverse, because the focal length are measured, it is a length, so SI unit of length is meter, so meter inverse. By using lens maker's formula, we are derived that 1 by f is equal to mu minus 1. So don't confuse students, in lens maker's formula you are written as mu 2 minus. So in lens maker's formula, 1 by f is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by mu 1 we are written. So this is the mu 2 is a refracting medium. So mu 1 is a air medium. So refractive index of the air is 1. So mu minus 1 by 1. So only we are writing these terms. Okay. So mu 2 minus 1 by mu 1 is a mu minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. So this is a power of lens formula for in terms of refractive index as well as the, what is that, radius of curvature. Mu is a refracting medium, and R1 and R2 are radius of curvatures of the convex lens. So dear students, understand the concept. Power of lens means degree of convergence or divergence of your lenses.